सुना था कि वो आएंगे अंजुमन में, सुना था कि उनसे मुलाकात होगी, हमें क्या पता था, हमें क्या खबर थी, ना ये बात होगी ना वो बात होगी। जनाब अज ते इस सफर विच मुलाकातां भी होणगियां ते गल्लां बातां भी, ते आओ फिर शुरुआत करदे अज दी पहली मुलाकात दे नाल। 1994 ਵਿੱਚ ਡੈਨਿਸਨ ਯੂਨੀਵਰਸਿਟੀ ਤੋਂ ਗ੍ਰੈਜੂਏਸ਼ਨ ਕਰਨ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਸਾਡੇ ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਮਹਿਮਾਨ ਕਈ ਫਿਲਮਾਂ ਲਈ ਰਾਈਟਰ, ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟਰ, ਪ੍ਰੋਡਿਊਸਰ, ਸਿਨੇਮਾਟੋਗ੍ਰਾਫਰ ਅਤੇ ਐਡੀਟਰ ਦੇ ਤੌਰ 'ਤੇ ਕੰਮ ਕਰ ਚੁੱਕੇ। ਇਹੀ ਨਹੀਂ, ਪਿਛਲੇ ਕਈ ਸਾਲਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਉਹ ਕਈ ਮਹੱਤਵਪੂਰਨ ਫਿਲਮ ਫੈਸਟੀਵਲਸ ਦੇ ਪੈਨਲਸ 'ਤੇ ਡਿਜੀਟਲ ਫਿਲਮ ਮੇਕਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਭਵਿੱਖ ਬਾਰੇ ਲੈਕਚਰਸ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਆਏ। ਇੱਕ ਫਿਲਮ ਨਿਰਦੇਸ਼ਕ ਦੇ ਤੌਰ 'ਤੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਫਿਲਮ ਬਿੰਗੋ ਦ ਡਾਕੂਮੈਂਟਰੀ ਨੇ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਕਈ ਸਨਮਾਨ ਹਾਸਲ ਕੀਤੇ, ਉੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਸੰਨ 2000 ਵਿੱਚ ਸਿਆਟਲ ਦੀ ਸਿਟੀ ਸਰਚ .com ਦੁਆਰਾ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਸਿਆਟਲ ਦਾ ਬੈਸਟ ਫਿਲਮ ਮੇਕਰ ਦਾ ਖਿਤਾਬ ਮਿਲਿਆ। ਆਊਟਸੋਰਸਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਗਰਮਾ ਗਰਮ ਵਿਸ਼ੇ 'ਤੇ ਆਧਾਰਿਤ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਲੇਟੈਸਟ ਫਿਲਮ ਆਊਟਸੋਰਸ ਨੂੰ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਭਰ ਦੇ ਫਿਲਮ ਫੈਸਟੀਵਲਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਬੇਹੱਦ ਸਰਾਇਆ ਜਾ ਰਿਹਾ, ਅਤੇ ਸਿਆਟਲ ਇੰਟਰਨੈਸ਼ਨਲ ਫਿਲਮ ਫੈਸਟੀਵਲ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਸ ਫਿਲਮ ਨੂੰ ਆਡੀਅੰਸ ਦੀ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਪਸੰਦੀਦਾ ਫਿਲਮ ਹੋਣ ਲਈ ਗੋਲਡਨ ਸਪੇਸ ਨੀਡਲ ਅਵਾਰਡ ਜਿੱਤਣ ਦਾ ਵੀ ਸਨਮਾਨ ਪ੍ਰਾਪਤ ਹੋਇਆ। ਨਿਰਦੇਸ਼ਕ ਜੌਨ ਜੈਫਕੋਟ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲਣ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਆਓ ਵੇਖਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਫਿਲਮ ਆਊਟਸੋਰਸ ਦੀ ਇੱਕ ਝਲਕ।
Okay, what else? Yes, man, me. I do not understand item H403. H403. A lot of Americans wear these to sporting events.
But why, sir?
It's hard to explain. We just do. Yes.
I don't understand the purpose of A221.
A221. That's a burger brand. Americans eat a lot of beef, and some people like to burn their initials into their food with a red-hot iron before they eat it.
Why?
It's like a cattle brand. You know, the thing you use to burn a symbol into a cow with? No, in America, that's how you keep track of your cow, is branding.
With a red-hot iron?
Yeah.
But wouldn't the cow run away?
Oh, no, we only do it to baby cows. When they're, you know, small enough to hold them down. Yes, Asha?
A suggestion, Mr. Todd.
Go ahead.
You need to learn about India.
John, thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thanks for having me.
Congratulations on the movie. It's got great reviews. It's doing great. And, you know, film festivals all over the world has accepted it so well. How does it feel?
It's fantastic. You know, and it was, you know, it was a little scary initially because I didn't know how the Indian, you know, audience especially was going to respond to this film made by an American. Mm-hmm. And it's been wonderful to have the reception that I've had with the Indian audience.
So take us back to where the idea originated from. Is it true when you were in Nepal for 5 months, that's where the idea sort of come about?
Yeah, when I was a student at Denison, I did a semester abroad, and I really just wanted to go somewhere where they didn't speak English. I wanted some sort of experience, and I chose Nepal, and I was there in a cultural immersion program where I was living out in these very remote areas, living with villagers, and then coming back and living in Kathmandu, working at a Bhutanese refugee camp, and having a very different kind of experience. And then coming back to the U.S. was the first time I actually had a foreigner's perspective of where I came from. And it opened my eyes, and it made me just, you know, have a different perspective on so many things. And it was a story I wanted to try to share with my friends and with other people. And it stuck with me for a long time. And it wasn't until later, I'm living in Seattle now, and you hear stories about outsourcing, about Indians having to come to the U.S., and then Americans having to train them to replace them. And also, Americans were angry about calling Bank of America and getting Indians on the line. And so what I wanted, I thought, okay, well, here's an opportunity to take my experience of an American traveling abroad and mix it with this idea of outsourcing and globalization to try to tell this story in an accessible way, to really share this culture that I experienced and really enjoyed to an American audience who maybe haven't traveled as much.
Right. You've taken a very humorous angle in the movie, I must say. A lot of people can relate to the humor, and it definitely puts a smile to your face because, you know, we have gone through it as immigrants, and I think we go through it day to day as well, American lingo and English lingo. Yeah. So, you know, how much of it comes from your personal experiences when you were there?
So much of it. I mean, almost everything Todd experiences on his journey are things that I experienced, either living in Nepal or living in India and traveling there. And, you know, when you're dealing with a subject like outsourcing, which can be very, you know, big hot button issue, as well as globalization, I think comedy is one of the best ways to explore it. Mm-hmm. You know, I didn't want it to be something that was going to alienate people. I wanted tell a story where people weren't, you know, could go in there and enjoy it in a very accessible way. And and then be able to, you know, and I'll get some messages in there while you're laughing, but make it a really fun experience. Mm-hmm. And it's a good way to kind of get people talking about some of the issues.
Right. Now, did you get, you know, I'm sure there's been a positive response and there's been a bit of, you know, critical response as well. So how have you received it?
Well, you know, like I said, my biggest worries were how was the Indian audience was going to, because I really made it for an American audience mm-hmm. that I felt needed to, maybe hadn't had a chance to travel outside of the country before. And so it was really a chance to glimpse of an India that I experienced mm-hmm. that I didn't really see being portrayed in a lot of films made by Americans or Indians. There was a warmth that I experienced mm-hmm. and I wanted to get that across. And I think that's what the Indians really responded to, more mm-hmm. so than I ever anticipated. And so that's been amazing. Some of the negative reviews I've been getting are mm-hmm. from Americans who actually had never traveled to India. And it's really interesting for me to hear them mm-hmm. with these very angry reviews telling me how, you know, it's just stereotypes and this and that.
Right.
And I'm getting Indians coming up after the screen saying, you got it just right, it was perfect. And that, you know, those are the people I really am listening to. Yeah. So, you know, not everyone's going to like it,
but
luckily the majority of people the response has been very positive.
Now, you actually filmed most of the film in India.
Yeah.
So I can't imagine what was that like, because, you know, being from North America and that sort of work style and then going back and shooting in India is completely day and night. So how was that experience?
It was really good, actually. We made a conscious decision to work with Indian crews. Mm-hmm. We didn't want to bring over our crews from the U.S. because we felt it was, you know, the movie is all about, you know, cultures working together, getting to know each other. Mm-hmm. And we thought, you know, I knew from my experience working on a documentary on the Indian film industry, the infrastructure was there, mm-hmm. the talent was there. And it was just a matter of figuring out how we can work together, and we understood so that the business-wise, we know how transactions are going to work. And we came over with just a few of us. Our cinematographer came from New York, and our sound crew came from New York as well, because sync sound is something very new in India, and there's only a couple people doing it. And then we also brought over a script supervisor, because continuity isn't really a big issue in Bollywood movies. So
No, it's not.
And then we worked with all these, at times we had a crew of 150 people. Mm-hmm. And we had a great company that we hired to help facilitate, the jobs. Uh-huh. And most of the crew was just, they were used to working with European commercials and mm-hmm. European films, so they knew the lingo, they knew how we wanted to work. And mm-hmm. we learned a lot of tricks from them, they learned stuff from us, and it was really a wonderful experience.
I can't imagine shooting in sync sound in Bombay. Yeah. It's a really, really busy city, as we all know. A lot of hustle and bustle. So that must have been a challenge.
It was a huge challenge. And not only that, but in a lot of our movie takes place in this little town called Garapuri, mm-hmm. which is supposed to be a small town. And we're trying to shoot this small town in Bombay.
Right.
And that was a real challenge, to find a location that was quiet enough. And then the other thing was, if we ever had to travel anywhere, the traffic in Bombay is probably worse than anywhere else in the world that I've ever experienced.
Yes, it is.
And so just getting your crew, if you had to do a location change, you know, it was just a nightmare. Even though it was maybe a half a mile away, it was just terrible. But but other than that, you know, it was really fun, and the energy was fantastic. Mm-hmm. Bombay is that, it's a city, I had a real love-hate relationship with it. And, you know, I went there, and I thought it was interesting, then I hated it, and then I went away, and I came back, and then you get to meet the people, and you get brought into the real Bombay, and that's mm-hmm. when I really started to love it. And now it's like a home away from home that I always look forward to going back. And
as I said, I'm sure the people can't wait to watch this film. What's next? What's coming up?
Well, we actually pitched this movie as a TV show idea to mm-hmm. the networks in the U.S., mm-hmm. and NBC bought it. Mm-hmm. And so now we are developing a global workplace comedy for NBC, uh-huh. And I'm in the process of writing the pilot with my co-writer. And my co-writer and I will be executive producers and lead writers on the show, and so we're hoping to bring our global workplace in India to primetime U.S. television.
Well, I see is success for you ahead of you.
Thank you
so much, John. Thanks for being here with us.
Yeah.
ਸਾਡੇ ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਅਗਲੇ ਮਹਿਮਾਨ ਤਿਆਰ ਬੈਠੇ ਨੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਵੀ ਤਿਆਰ ਹੋ ਜਾਓ ਕੁਝ ਹੀ ਪਲਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ